Today, we're going to review a new series on Netflix called The Perfect Couple.
We do have to get ahead of things.
I'm going to kill her.
I did not see that coming.
Neither did I.
Nope.
These people are used to getting whatever they want. The minute they feel they're losing control, they burn it all down.
Dad!
Even the best of liars get very tired. All gets too overwhelming, and they snap.
It's got a great cast, including Nicole Kidman and Liev Schreiber.
And it is a classic whodunit, and quite frankly, even I, who normally guess, haven't figured it out until about the fifth or sixth. Actually, I think the fifth installment.
Well, it is a miniseries, and I love the fact that it is six episodes. I wanted to just briefly say that it's based on a book by Ellen Hildebrand, and she is, I've read a couple of her books, she writes about Nantucket, and she writes about the rich people on Nantucket and the poor people meaning anybody who's not rich, not really poor, you know, just working class people. And that's what this situation is. We arrive at a very rich family's house on the water in Nantucket for a wedding. And the son of the rich couple is going to marry a girl of modest means, working class family. They've fallen in love. And all the friends are coming from all over. So there's a large, large gathering of people. And don't you know it, somebody dies. Well,
really?
The bridesmaid. The bride's best friend. And of course, was it an accident? We don't know for sure yet, you know, and the police come in. And it really is the classic whodunit because everybody becomes a suspect. The further you get into the show, the more you find out how imperfect the perfect couple is. And you find out how many other couples in this story are imperfect couples. It's a wonderful plot, wonderful story, very well done by Ellen Hildebrand. And I'm so glad they made it a miniseries. It's really great cast. You love the cast.
Yeah, by the way, as John has just said, the ability for them to spend 6 hours for six one-hour segments, okay, provides all the richness that you would lose if they cut it down to an hour and a half feature film. So I agree, it was well done that way. But what is really remarkable about this is that as many of the miniseries that we haven't reviewed, is that it was a terrific cast. All of the characters were believable, well-performed. Anybody could have done it, but in the end, you'll find out who done it. But there are two surprises for me among all of the people who were not well known to me. One is the one who played Detective Henry, okay, who was very, very, I would say, Columbo-esque.
Good description, yeah.
Unassuming, but you knew that she was going to nail it. There was no question she was going to nail it, but how long was it going to take? And the other surprise was a wonderful the bride to be Amelia, played by Eve Hewson, who I didn't look up until the very end of who she was because I was fascinated. Turns out she's Bono's daughter, Bono the rock singer, I read enough about a backstory that she was discouraged from performing. They didn't want her to do it. And she wound up eventually, she went to a lot of schools for acting and wound up, I think, graduating from NYU. You can check this out yourself. I think with a degree in psychology. Smart, but she just played the role so well.
Yeah. Well, in many ways, even though they promote Liev Schreiber and
Nicole Kidman,
and Nicole Kidman as the stars, in many ways, the real main character is Eve Hewson, is Amelia, the bride-to-be. of course, what's wonderful is the, as you point out, the richness of the story. Every character is well developed. There's so many rich kids in there that I'd want to slap across the face, you know, and there's so many poor people that I want to slap across the face and say, what the hell are you doing? You know, again, poor being a relative term, working class, anything, anybody who's not mega rich is, quote, poor on Nantucket. But it's a great story, a lot of twists and turns because you don't know who's done it. And the ending is worth sticking around for.
Absolutely. Even the ending after they found out who done it, okay,
yes,
and the person is arrested, and then there's yes, so, and 1 year later.
Yes. Anyway, please do make time to watch The Perfect Couple on Netflix. And give them good feedback. It's a good show.
For more on Celebrating Act Two, visit our webpage, follow us on Facebook, subscribe to us on YouTube, and tell your friends. Celebrating Act Two is the user manual for the second half of your life.